Hello, hello, my name is Raidoboost, and in this video I will show you how to download and install Autodesk Revit 2021. My general recommendation is that you first download your files and then start the installation, which simply enables you to reinstall or install it into multiple machines more easily. To be able to download those files, you can go to any official Autodesk website, and for example autodesk.com/revit, you can find download free trial. But of course, if you are educational user, you can go to autodesk.com education and find download from here, Revit 2021. Or if you are current Autodesk user, business or educational, then you can find those updated versions also from manage.autodesk.com. From here, you can just find the version you like, click view downloads, and then you can select your version, platform, and language. You can select also download method. And once again, my recommendation is to use download now, not install now. And once you do that, download now, you should get the notification about Open Autodesk Download Manager. Let's do that. This is small product which enables to download those files more easily. You just select the location to where those files are downloaded. In my case, I usually use my portable drive, but it's up to you. And of course, those installation files can be quite big. That's the reason why I usually keep those separately. Currently, this 2021 could be about 16 gigabytes. I won't do that right now. I hit cancel because I already have downloaded those files. If those files are downloaded, the installation starts immediately, but you can cancel it and do the installation at any time you like. And this is what I'm doing as a next step. So I close this, I minimize my browser, I navigate to the location from where I can find those downloaded files using Download Manager. And from here, I find setup.exe. I do double click to start the installation. Once the installation screen is loaded, you can see main button install, and you can directly go to installation. But I would also like to point out that before you start the installation, maybe you haven't done it yet, but please take a look to system requirements, that you meet minimum system requirements, and also some release notes. You can find some additional products under install tools and utilities, but this time I will skip this and I go directly to install. So left click. I get a license agreement page from where I can select my country or region. I read through the license terms and then I can accept and hit next. And then I can see which components can be installed. And I can also modify what I would like to include or not. Currently, by default, I can also see how much disk space do I need. It's about 8 gigabytes, and I do have enough space available. I can also change installation path. I usually keep it as default, program files and Autodesk. But let's now turn our attention to those different products and components. Let's start from top to down. First, Autodesk Revit. You just do left click to open it up, and then you can see what subcomponents will be installed as well. For example, Formit add-in. Yes, I do want to have that. I also want to have fabrication configuration, but because I'm metric user, I deselect Imperial. You may do the opposite. I also want to include desktop shortcut. My content path is important, from where I can find content, and then project path. Those can be changed at later times if you want to, but because I'm installing it into my local machine, then those are good to go. I do left click to close it up, and then let's move forward. Core content for Revit. You can't do left click here because families and templates will be installed automatically. This is quite a change from previous versions. In previous versions, you were able to select different country packs, but now core content is installed automatically. I then move forward, and by default, I have selected US-based families, basically US metric. This is what I have been using so far. If you would like to have UK-based families, then you just select this. If you want German, if you want to add some additional countries or other family libraries, then you should point to this web location from where you can download additional country packs. I also want to add material libraries. Those are also selected. Okay, basically that's it. I can now hit install, and then all those components will be installed, 40 together. And once this number counts to zero, then my products should be installed, and hopefully successfully. So let's come back when this number is zero and I should see a final installation screen. Once installation is finished, you should see a similar screen in where those check marks just indicate that product or component was successfully installed. If you don't, maybe you see red cross mark, then there is always a notification what you can do to be able to install it again. Basically, if you see a button launch now, it will fire up your Revit 2021 straight away. But you can also close this dialog first. And if you do need to restart your machine, you should do it. But let's find out our Revit 2021 icon. It's included onto my desktop as well. Just double click. I then see a dialog which states, do I want to start a trial? Yes, I do want to start the trial. But if you already have a license, you can also include this license information, or you can subscribe as a new user. But right now, start trial. User interface will load. I can close down this notification that 30 days left of trial, just clicking on this cross. In 2021 release, it's a possibility that you tune up your user interface by clicking start. I really do not want to do that right now, so I close this. And this is my Revit 2021 desktop, from where I can open up my recent files or start a new one. Let's start a new empty project by clicking this new button, left click. I can then select a template. Let's pick maybe architecture, and then ensuring that create new is selected, I hit OK. Okay, my full user interface is loaded. For example, ribbon with different tabs from where I can find tools, toolsets. I also have my properties palette, which I normally keep it as it is, left hand side, but you can of course drag it and place it maybe to the right hand side, and then again to the left hand side. And then I have also project browser, which divides my project into different views. Is it a plan view, section, or 3D view, or maybe schedule? I also want to check my content and my content location. For that, I can go to File and Options. From here, I click File Location, and I can find my templates, which is kind of key thing in Revit, as it is in many Autodesk products. I can also find my family templates, and I can change this path to something else. Right now, everything looks good. I hit OK, and to be sure, I go to Manage, select Project Units. My unit system in current template is what I'm looking for, meaning that metric unit system is currently in use. If I go to Insert tab and click Load Family, then I can see my default libraries in folder structure, libraries, and English. If I'm Imperial user, then I might be interested about English Imperial, and I should change that also in my options. But I also have some additional content packs which I may or may not require, and therefore if I don't need those, I can delete. But I can see that the main part is a key amount of space, so additional packages are a lot less. Okay, I cancel it, and I'm good to go with my own examples or just studying the software. I also want to point out that once I have installed new products, I should also check Autodesk desktop app to find out if I have some additional updates that are ready to install on top of my recent installations. Right now, I can see that I do have some plugins available directly from Autodesk app screen, for example, lighting analysis and solar analysis, but also some additional plugins. including Revit InfraWorks Updater when I'm working with InfraWorks. Okay, so that's about installation of Autodesk Revit 2021. Maybe in my future videos, I will take a deep dive into some new features. If you want to get notification about those videos, please do subscribe to my channel. And as easy as that, happy learning and bye-bye.